Hi there, Serdar Yegulov here from InfoWorld.IDG. In my last video, I talked about how dictionaries could be used to pull off some advanced programming techniques in Python. What you might not know is that dictionaries are used throughout Python under the hood, and many of the lookup techniques we used before with dictionaries can be used in many other places in Python. In Python, everything is an object, and its attributes, all the things in the object, including information about the object itself, are stored in dictionaries. We can access those dictionaries in Python and so get objects to tell us about what's stored in them and use that to our advantage. I've created an example here, a class that takes in a command in the form of a string and looks up a corresponding method by name in the class's attributes. This way, we don't have to write code that wires up commands to specific methods. We can just look up the methods by name with a little care against abuse and run the associated method automatically. In this class, we can take one of three commands, go, pause, and quit. When we pass a command to the command method, in the form of string, it uses the getAttribute function, a Python built-in, to see if there is an attribute in the class that matches the name. If it doesn't find an attribute that matches, it falls back to the command other function as a safety. And we could add some other safeties on top of this, like screening the input that we receive from the user. That way we can prevent untrusted user input from wreaking havoc. But this is the basic idea for now. Now again, as with dictionaries generally, the time needed for each lookup remains more or less constant no matter how many objects there are in the dictionary. So we could have a class with 50 methods, and it would take the same amount of time to look any one of them up. Another advantage of this pattern is it reduces the amount of boilerplate that we have to write. We can write less code and get more results. Here, all I have to focus on is the code that's actually in the class to perform the functions, instead of the mechanisms needed to look up a function and associate it with a command. If you like this video, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube, and for more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.